Sooner Scoop HD.
Concussion. How do you came through, you played pretty well today. Can you talk about just everything that went into that week in preparation for, I mean, going through the protocol?
Yep.
And when did you know you were going to be back?
Kind of had a clue on, you know, this Wednesday. Felt like we had a chance Texas week, but just, you know, really trusted the docs and trusted, you know, the trainers. Knew they were trying to get me back as fast as possible, but also to protect me at the same time. So just trusted them. And then throughout the week, just a bunch of conversations, a bunch of, you know, concussion tests, and then meeting with the doc 2 to 3 times a week. But, you know, thankfully, like I said, just got the full clearance this week and felt really good to be back out there.
How frustrating was it not to play last week?
Obviously. Yeah, it was. I mean, it's tough. You know, you see your guys that you work so hard with and feel like, you know, I wasn't out there to help, you know, be with them. And obviously it left a bad taste in all of our mouths, but shoot, just had to keep grinding and find a way to come out on top. And I think that's what I love about our guys. They're very selfless and look themselves in the mirror and see how can they be better for this team. And I feel like everyone did a good job about that this week.
Dylan, I know you're not going to be put out there. Doctors aren't going to put you out there without you being healthy.
Yep.
But still to have gone through what you went through,
yep,
and have the side effects and all the problems, how much of a mental hurdle was that to overcome? And then the physical side of it, how much of a hurdle was that?
I think it was a lot to comprehend at the time, just because of, you know, obviously the hit in general or the backlash. But most importantly, you know, I just took the 2 days, you know, the first 48 hours super, just being super cautious, you know, not being on my phone, not being on any TVs or watching anything. I think I was maybe awake for 8 hours a day, you know, sleeping most of the day. So just made that a point of emphasis, you know, listen to the trainers. And like I said, they just put me in a good spot. And I'm lucky, you know, to even get cleared this week because of, you know, a lot of people, it's just the severity of it is different for everyone. But, you know, I took the healing process very seriously so that I could put myself in a good spot.
In between the mental and the physical, was there a moment today where you finally felt back? What was that first hit like where you just had to take it and you got up just fine?
To be quite honest, I didn't really think about it. Not too after the game when people are like, oh, you know, I was, you know, watching you and worried about you. But, you know, it's football. It's an aggressive game. You know what you're getting into every time you step on that field. And, you know, it's just, like I said, I'm grateful for every opportunity I step out there because I know, you know, this game's aggressive. Things are going to happen. I know there wasn't any malicious intent in any of it. And it's football. People are going to, you know, I'm going to get hit. So just being smart, trying to protect myself, and also not taking any unnecessary hits. So,
what were the reasons for yours, not yours necessarily, but yep, for the offensive success? I mean, the numbers were just outlandish, 700 yep, yards, 100 yep, snaps and all that. What would you attribute this success to?
Just continuing to be aggressive, but also trusting our guys, you know, in space. And when we do well in the run game and do well in the perimeter, it, you know, naturally just gives us a chance to take shots. And when we connect on those shots and big plays and, you know, create an explosive plays, there's momentum involved, there's you know, confidence involved, but also setting the tone in the first drive. So I think it all has a, you know, plays a part in being successful in offense. But there's, like I said, things to clean up. It's just when you win, those things look not as bad. So
it seemed like, obviously, did you know the coverage you guys are going to get at play one? Because you guys were aggressive from the get-go. I mean, you guys took a shot at with Marvin Mims first play, and then after that, it seemed like you were trying to hit 15-plus yards on the field at least 2 or 3 times on the drive.
Yeah, just like I said, we trust our coaches, and got a lot of trust in the building for, you know, them putting us in the best position possible. I think we had one of our best weeks, you know, preparing, in the sense of, you know, just the focus, the energy, the juice at practice. but continue to replicate that so we can, you know, go out and have that type of, you know, production. So,
two other guys that you looked up to through the years?
Tough to say, just because I've played against them before. Played a quarter against them before the lights went out. My sophomore year in high school, but definitely a guy, you know, I look at as just a guy representing Hawaii and doing it very well.
The reason I ask is I just wonder if you've had a chance to reach out to him about his concussion just a couple weeks ago.
I haven't, but, you know, the crazy timing of it, I think it, you know, led to a lot of, you know, people just being a lot more cautious with certain hits. I think you see the Colts running back as well, and the Baylor quarterback going through a similar deal. I think it's just people are a lot more cautious, and there's a lot more eyes on it because of the severity of Tua's, and how scary it can get if you're not protected or fully healed. So haven't been able to reach out to him, but, you know, prayers to him, and he's representing Hawaii in a hell of a way. So.
Dylan, Braden said that there was a point during meetings this week when you guys are watching film, everybody got spread out, and you got everybody down to the front to be together.
Yep.
He said he felt like that was sort of like, oh, here's our guy. Was that an important moment for you to sort of, I mean, I know getting back on the field is the most important today, but was that a moment for you to be thought, things are starting to, this feels like I remember it before, sort of?
Yeah, I think with that certain situation, I just, it's such a little thing, but, you know, when guys are spread out and sitting far back and there's kind of seats in between, I like to fill it up, you know what I mean? Make sure we're all close. And like I said, it's so little, but it's also a big thing in making sure, you know, we're all committed and whatever, you know, people say, let's go do it, you know, with whatever it is. So it's funny looking back at that, because we were just joking around, having a bunch of fun. But, you know, like I said, the little things truly do matter.
You ever had a ball slip out of your hand like that?
I mean, not like that. But, gosh, I don't know. It's such a weird play, but not a good one for sure. But just a weird play, you know. Overall, so
on that touchdown pass to Marvin, what'd you see there? You'd been going to him a couple plays before that. Yeah. Did you see something that kind of led to getting him so open?
Not necessarily. Just which touchdown is Marvin?
On the left sideline, was that Marvin where he ran the double move and then
Theo? Oh, Theo, it was Theo.
Sorry, my bad.
I thought you were talking about the other one that was close.
Stopped, yeah.
Yeah, but Theo's one. No, yeah, just. Like I said, I know they're playing soft early on and want to take advantage of that. But, you know, the moment they start squeezing down on it and trying to just making them stay honest, you know, making sure they're not jumping it, but taking advantage of that opportunity.
Dylan, was it hard at all not? I mean, you come back and you guys are on a 3-game losing streak. Everybody wants to, you know, get going offensively. Was it difficult at all not to find yourself pressing today? Because it didn't seem like you did at all.
Yeah, not. I mean, I don't think it's a moment of stress or a moment of, you know, being over the top with it and trying to do too much. But just continue to play within the system and doing our job to the best of our ability. The moment you try to, you know, do too much, or you just end up forcing things and not having good things happen. So I just, you know, tried to, like I said, come back, do what I'm asked, and do it to the best of my ability. Likewise for everyone.
Dylan, how would you describe kind of your emotions after the game, where you coming back, the losing streak over, and the offense that was shut out last week seeming to be revived now? A lot of things going on.
It feels good. A win feels good, and I'll never take that for granted. But like I said, it's good for our team and something that we needed. Because of how, you know, you see it week to week how hard, you know, everyone works, and when you don't reap the benefits, sometimes it's tough. But you got to continue to trust the process and continue to work just as hard, and know that, you know, at some point when you keep, you know, digging, the gold will come. So Just continue to trust that, and I'm proud of our guys.
Is this the fastest you felt that you guys have been able to play this year? Obviously, having Kansas on the hills, almost the whole game. Well, you guys like playing fast, but was that the game plan to come in and play that fast the whole game?
I think at a certain point, there's a point of emphasis during the week, kind of getting back to that. But also, I know when we play fast, certain things are going well, with explosive plays or just positive plays in general. It allows you to play faster. But, yeah, as much as we can play fast, we'd love to. So.
Is this the most pressure you've ever felt as a quarterback or as a football player in general, just this program and being on a three-game losing streak, something that hasn't happened since the 90s?
I wouldn't say pressure. Definitely a different situation for a lot of the guys, but we can't control what happened 3 weeks ago or the past 3 weeks, but we can control, the now and trying to, respond the right way. And, I'm proud of our guys because it ain't easy. You know what I mean? Nobody, plans it out losing 3 weeks in a row. And taking that to the chin 3 weeks in a row is not easy. But how we responded, continue to see the guys, just grind every single day. That's how you respond the right way, and that's all we could control. So.
Sooner Scoop HD.